is something called as a collar friction. So there was a case like this. So there was a load W here, load acting downwards, and then the torque or the power lost in friction or the torque at this place, how much it is, considering the given dimensions that was already derived earlier back. So from that you say that T2 is given by mu into W. Mu is, in this case it is mu1, coefficient of friction at the collar. So mu1 into the vertical load W into the formula is the radius R3 plus R4 upon 2. So T2 is coefficient of friction into vertical load into R3 plus R4 upon 2. R3 plus R4 is the radius. We are going to find out this surface. So outside surface is D4, radius is R4. Inside surface is D3, radius is R3 here. So R3 plus R4 upon 2, this is T2. So now we know both T1 and T2. So once you know T1 and T2, now you can say that torque is known now. And once the torque is known, now whatever is applied over here, then you can find out. So how do you now design this particular rod? This rod, as you see here, diameter D. So bending stress on the rod, to design the rod, to find out the size of the handle means to design rod for or handle for bending stress. So as you can see, this is under bending stress. So for the bending stress, the formula is Ft design is equal to M upon Z. Now M is the moment acting over here is what you are going to apply by your effort, by hand and the distance. So I will put right here, M in this case is nothing but the torque itself. And Z is pi d cube by 32. Pi d cube by 32 into Ft design is equal to torque. What you are applying there as a torque is same as moment which you are applying on the handle. So by doing this you can find out D, that is the size of the handle. So D is the size of the handle. Now the length of the handle, to find the length of the handle, now the notation is say from here to here LH, length of handle. Now length of handle is given by torque T is equal to P dash into length of handle, where P dash is effort by hand. And this is given. So you know how much is the effort you can apply by hand, how much is the torque you want to produce, and that will give you how much is the length of the handle you need to have. So you know the length of the handle, you know the diameter of the handle. So at this stage you can say the handle is designed. Now you can go for the rest of the size of the head. So to find the height of the head, etc., that will be due next.